All right, guys, well, you can see here I finally had some success with getting the motherboard out of this out of the main shell of the Asus G73 laptop. It was kind of difficult. It took a long time. Some of the screws were stripped, so that didn't really help. I mean, this is the first time I've ever taken it apart, but other than factory, one factory restore, one factory repair, it hasn't been taken apart other than that I can remember. So someone from Asus must have had their hand in stripping some of the screws. Anyways, I'll show you some of the stuff I did. So here's the piece that goes over the graphics chip. Sorry, this camera's probably not in the best spot. Can see a little more. Sorry. So I have this part of the heat sink. This part goes to the fan, and this is the portion that goes over the graphics chip. I don't know if I have this oriented properly. I think it actually goes this direction. And it's the screws are in. They're not in right now, but they would go over this. And there's this other component that is mounted on top of the CPU. I'll have to refer to my pictures to see exactly how this was. It was either this direction or the other direction. No, it can't be that way. It must have been this direction. So yeah, it's the other fan goes here because this laptop has two fans, one for the GPU, one for the CPU. And I mean, this is my desk. It's kind of a disaster. I have a bunch of tools laying out, and I just want to show you. I mean, maybe I've posted a picture before. But there was a lot going on once I took off this this heat sink. I saw that there was a lot of there was thermal compound here, which is that's normal. There was some on these other parts up on this part of the heat sink on the bottom, also on these components as well. It was kind of dripping all over. It was melted kind of all in here. Pretty much it was like just down here, melted around. There was some more thermal compound on top of the NVIDIA card. Also there's this, they're kind of one of these on top of the NVIDIA card, as well as one of these on top of the CPU. You can see they have like some type of glue or tape type stuff on it, on them, as well as thermal compound. They can't really get it off of this one. This one was from the CPU. They can't really get it off of this one too well. But you can see that the thermal compound that they used was, it was kind of everywhere. So that was the first thing after taking off these heat sink pieces. The first thing was just to clean off all the thermal compound, all the paste. It was over here, it was on all of these components, on the chips as well. And it was also on these little plastic, these little pieces as well. another thing I did so far was I took this little butane torch, and I mean, It was on. Well, it's not on right now, but you can hear. Like it's a butane torch basically. Just kind of turn it on, turn it up, and then touch it near a flame, and then it ignites, and then you can use it, just not burning the video card, but kind of in kind of a circular motion, not even this close. Like the flame was blue and it was hot, and it wasn't too hot, but I was pretty far up from it, just making sure the card wasn't gonna get burned. I don't want to like burn or damage any components. I was just trying to heat it so that if there's any solder under here that's kind of not settled anymore, or that has kind of been unsettled by such heavy usage and by possibly not being cooled down enough, hopefully reheating it would have kind of settled more solder into some of the little gaps that there might be under here. I didn't take this off at all. I just left it on. I took I removed the CPU just to kind of look underneath the chip and kind of see, just to make sure the pins were all there, make sure all the pins fit, make sure there weren't any like bent pins or anything that was kind of like in the way. So the pins are all right. Everything looked okay as far as just looking. I have helping hands, and I have a little magnifying glass on it. I kind of use this little guy, and you can see through it pretty good. It kind of magnifies things pretty well so that you can kind of tell what's up underneath there. So that's mainly what I did. I guess I used this kind of rubbing alcohol. Maybe I should have used more, like 90%, 90, I don't know. But this was just first aid rubbing alcohol that I had around. Some other things, I needed to fill the butane torch, so I used this Burn-O-Matic, because it's a Burn-O-Matic butane torch. I used the Burn-O-Matic, am I saying that right? Yes, Burn-O-Matic torch. As well as the Burn-O-Matic butane. Keeping these on the floor because they're combustible and I don't want to like knock them down off of my desk. I use this duster. I got most of this stuff from Home Depot. So yeah, they have some good stuff. This was ozone safe duster. I use this in the fans and in the backs of these vents for the fans. They were just caked with dust. They're pretty dirty. I tried to blow it out with my breath and I couldn't, so there's just dust everywhere. What else? These are some more RAM that were in on underneath here that I couldn't access until I took the motherboard out. So these are just two more. I think they're both 2 gigs. Yeah, 2 gigs of RAM. So I took those out as well. I like this butane torch. Just a quick note. I kind of like it. It has like a soldering point. You can see the soldering point. You can remove that, and it has another piece here you can use for a flame. I also have a soldering iron just in case, because I'm always kind of, sometimes there might be a loose piece or some kind of capacitor or some type of piece that's kind of just like loose that might need to be kind of more firmly fixed onto the board. There was a piece I kind of knocked off right here, this one. As I was saying, I had some trouble taking off the heat sink, and basically what happened was the heat sink was bolted on with these screws. So this screw here, it's still in, but it was okay. There were one, two, three, four screws here. These screws, I mean, these are labeled. So the four was okay, the one was okay, the two was okay, but this three right here, I don't know, it was hard to get it off. And the thermal compound was kind of like sticking this piece to the board, so it was really hard to kind of get this thing out. Basically, what I ended up doing was I took out all the other screws that I could take out, and I did probably the dumbest thing possible, but I was trying to get under here. So what I did was I kind of noticed that these kind of lifted a bit, so I kind of had to keep the screw in and just lift this piece a bit over these plastic pieces here. And I think I ended up knocking off this piece here, but I had to lift it up and over to about this angle till I was able to get the screw to a point where I could actually unscrew things. So at that point, the screw was kind of loosened. And another thing about that screw is there's a bottom part to that screw, so I had to unscrew the part from the bottom. That part was simple to take off. For some reason, though, this top one right here was just, it was a pain to try and get out. And there's another one too. I mean, I originally was gonna take off this whole component right here, because you can see you can take it off, and it slides into this connector here. Sorry, there's a shadow, but it slides into this connector here. But basically, I decided, let me not take this whole thing off, because it's a pain. Because this screw right here, I was having so much trouble trying to get it out. I was like, let me just keep this component in the board and connected, and I'll just have to take off this piece instead. So I took this piece off and I kept this connected, because I was unable to remove this screw as well. So both of those screws were stripped. They were already stripped before I even started, but I didn't notice it until I started trying to take things apart. And once I got to this point, I noticed that, hey, the screws are stripped, and there's not really much I can do about it. And I didn't want to not use this butane torch. My main thing first off was to use the butane torch and try to reheat any kind of solder joints that are kind of maybe loose, kind of just resettle the solder underneath this chip, the graphics chip. So I mean, I did the best I could with that. I've never done it before, but I am hoping with all the instruction I got from others and all of the helpful hints and video tutorials and the cool people from Radio Shack that kind of helped me out with some information as well, I was able to kind of get the piece off, and I was also able to heat the GPU unit. And other than that, now I need to use the thermal paste. I'm going to use this Arctic Silver 5. So, I mean, it's about $10 for this at Radio Shack. I didn't check anywhere else. I just tried to go to one spot and get all my things, Radio Shack and Home Depot. So, oh, if you want to know too, this butane torch is about $10 at Home Depot. And I think the butane itself, the can of butane, was about five, maybe $3 to $5. So yeah, what I need to do now is I'm gonna use this Arctic Silver 5. I'm going to apply it to the GPU, the CPU. I mean, I'm debating with myself if I should put these original plastic pieces back on top where they were. I mean, I had so much trouble getting these off, and I also, I mean, the solder was melted so much that it was, not the solder, sorry, the thermal compound was melted all over this board so much that I had to actually use a pocket knife to scrape away, like gently, but scrape away a lot of it so that I could actually use the alcohol and a rag to kind of wipe it down more. So all right, we'll see how much further I get with this part of the project. And all right, thanks for tuning in.